Hi, this is Tom Ladd for the 2019 Ozark Baseball Preview Magazine. We're spotlighting our cover selections from the Aurora Hound Dogs, the state champs. Gage Singer, part of the cover selections this year. Congratulations, quite an honor.
Yeah, thank you.
Guys, coming off a couple good seasons at Aurora, memorable seasons for sure. Talk about your play first off.
I'm just blessed to have been a part of this. You know, it's been a great high school season, or all my seasons have been very memorable moments, and just good to be a part of it.
Your numbers look like this: 4-0 on the mound, couple saves, 0.8 earned run average, in 34 innings, 70 strikeouts on the mound. It's pretty good.
Yeah, I just got into pitching last year, so it's kind of new to me, and so I'm still kind of getting the feel of things.
I mean, that's pretty good numbers right there, 34 innings, 70 strikeouts.
Yeah, I'm still getting used to it.
Well, 478 batting average as well, 6 homers, 40 RBIs, dangerous hitter from what I understand. What do you like better? If you're just getting into pitching, you must like the offense better at this point.
Honestly, I like them both the same. You know, I just love the game. So anytime I get to play, I'm happy.
Two straight state titles. I mean, it's just unheard of anymore, especially around this area. There's good baseball in this area.
Yeah, there is a lot of good players, a lot of good teams in Southwest Missouri. You know, our district's one of the hardest to get out of, and we've just been very fortunate the last few years.
Big question, is a cupboard bare? I know it's not with you coming back, but what else does Aurora have coming back?
Oh, we got a few juniors that's going to make an impact, and we're going to be young, and so those kids are going to have to step up, and they got big shoes to fill, and we're excited.
You in for the leadership role this year?
Yeah, I believe so.
Have to be, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Forced into it. James Hoffman of the state champions alongside as well. Talk about your cover selection here.
He's just a special player, extremely talented. Everybody knows that he can swing the bat. I think he's going to surprise a lot of people. You know, with our pitching staff the last several years, he hasn't really got an opportunity. Last year he stepped on the mound for us, and I mean, whenever he was on there, like the numbers say, he was dominant. You know, but I mean, a lot of people don't know. I mean, he's just an unbelievable leader. His leadership skills and qualities are, you know, probably some of the best we've ever had. He knows what we expect out of our kids and does a phenomenal job of promoting that within the rest of the guys. And you know, if somebody steps out of line, doesn't know what's going on, he's one of the first ones to jump up and you know, show them the way.
Well, just listening to him, sounds very coachable. If the guy hadn't pitched, really kind of just took up the pitching part of it and did so well, it must be a very coachable player.
Most definitely. You know, he's a student of the game. He wants to learn. You know, a lot of kids get into spots where they've, you know, done this or that for so many years, and they're difficult, to say the least, and he's open about anything. He's a smart enough kid to know that there's more than one way to do things, and, you know, he's open to try about anything.
Couple state championships under your belt the past 2 years. Lost some good talent. What do you got coming back?
We have. We've lost some really high quality players. You know, obviously with Gage coming back, that's a big time plus. But we've got some kids who are going to have to step up into roles that they've never been in before. We've got another good junior arm in Jay Lee who's going to shoulder a lot of innings. And then, you know, as far as the rest of the staff, we've got some kids who are capable. To pitch at the varsity level, we've just got to get them ready probably a year earlier than what they were supposed to.
I know you guys play a very tough schedule in preparation for your postseason, and that'll be the case this year too.
Most definitely, we've added some more Class 5 schools to you know, challenge our kids. I mean, my thought process is if we're going to go anywhere in the postseason, we've got to challenge our kids before we get there.
Gage, talk college. What's going on with you next year?
I'm going to Crowder. I signed November, and I'm excited.
Not a better JUCO program in the Midwest than Crowder. They really develop guys for the next level if they want to go on. Talk about your decision to go there.
Oh, you know, I've known some kids that went through there, and they prepare their kids for the next level. I like how they you know, get in the cage and work and, you know, their practices. And like the coaching staff, you know, they're trustworthy, and that's just the place for me.
JUCO World Series just about every other year. I mean, that's a very successful program, and from that, a lot of the guys go on to play D1 or get drafted.
Yeah, they put a lot of guys up to the next level, and I just feel like with me, I get in there, they're going to show me what to do and, you know, guide me in the right direction.
Coach talked about the schedule, playing some even tougher teams this year, bumping it up to some more Class 5s. That okay with you?
Yeah, whatever gets us ready for the postseason. Yeah.
Well, we want to congratulate you again for being on the cover. Wish you the best of luck this season. Congratulations on the state championships as well.
Thank you.
Again, Gage Singer from Aurora and head coach James Hoffman. He is part of the 2019 Ozark Baseball Preview Magazine, our cover selections. And my name is Tom Ladd.